what would you say if I told you that I can't grow hair anywhere on my body and that everything you see here is fake?
Like this right here?
It's a wig.
And these right here are drawn.
And this here?
Actually, that one's real.
Okay, family, fun. You got me. It's not me who can't grow hair. It's the girl that we're gonna see in this video today. Because today, we're gonna be watching another true story animation about a girl who can't grow hair anywhere.
Nowhere on her body.
Girl, to be honest, I think that's a good thing. I've been trying to get the hair off my lip for years.
Oh, y'all haven't seen it? Look closer.
Hi there. My name is Grace. My mom was the head of a big tech company. And all she wanted was one perfect daughter to take over her business someday. So when I was born, she held me close and said,
"Oh, honey, you're the most perfect baby burrito I've ever seen.
And soon you're gonna be a business burrito."
Oh my God, she's so pretty. I'm the luckiest mom in the world. She was so happy that she gifted cars to all her employees.
She gifted what now to all the employees?
Okay, she ballin'.
But a few months later, she discovered something that turned her love into hatred for me. I was diagnosed with a medical condition called alopecia universalis congenita. I could never grow a hair on my body, not even my head. Mom went ballistic when she learned this. This girl's a freak. She can't be my daughter.
What the heck, Mama? Your daughter just got diagnosed with a lifelong disease and you be calling her a freak?
Dang.
Looks like you can buy all the cars you want, but I guess you can't buy a heart.
Cause you cold.
She even took back the cars she gifted to her employees and wanted me to stay out of her sight. But Dad left his job to stay home with me full time. And he completely adored me. When I was turning 4, I asked Dad to throw me a Mickey Mouse themed birthday party. Honey, your mom will go nuts if I suggest this. But Dad, she'll go nuts only if she finds out.
But Dad, you know Mama's gonna go crazy either way.
So I might as well have her go crazy with the Mickey Mouse birthday party.
With the help of Mickey Mouse's big old ears, it'll help Mama's screams go in ear and out the Mickey Mouse other. You know what I mean?
She'll go nuts only if she finds out. We can have the party when she's away. After a week, Mom did leave for a business trip.
Ciao, ciao, Meanie!
You won't be missed!
And Dad arranged for the best party ever. Just as I was about to blow the candles, Mom barged in. So you were just waiting for me to leave, huh?
Yeah, that's typically what people do when they have a toxic family member. Obviously, I wanted you gone!
She swept the cake off the table and sent it flying into the wall. What's there to celebrate about her? She can't even grow eyelashes! Well, how was that my fault? One day, when I was 5, I saw a long line of people standing outside, each one with a girl my age. When I ran to my parents and told them, Mom got up from the table. Oh good, the adoption people are here. What adoption? What are you talking about? I contacted different adoption agencies to bring me the best girls. I need a daughter with hair to represent my company one day.
This mama really has the nerve to hold whole auditions for a new child. Can someone please tell this mom that this isn't an iPhone that you can get tired of and trade in for a newer model? This is a human being. Yes, she might have been half human and half baby burrito when she was born, but now she's grown up to be a full flipping kid. You can't just toss her in the garbage like that. Kids don't just expire.
I stared at her and blinked away angry tears. But Dad really lost it. He threatened to leave Mom if she didn't send all those people away instantly. Reluctantly, she did, but the whole thing made me so mad. I ran to my room and broke the frame that had a picture of Mom holding me as a baby. When I turned 6, I was all excited to finally join school, but of course, Mom threw a tantrum. She's not going anywhere looking like that. I have a reputation to maintain.
Reputation to maintain? Girl, I think your reputation is already sealed shut. And that reputation is being a terrible person.
Fine, Mom. I won't be going out looking like that. I made Dad take me to the mall to buy a wig and fake eyelashes. And then I made him draw eyebrows on my face. I looked perfect. Mom was still super annoyed when she saw me, but Dad marched me off to school to get me enrolled right away. It took me 2 hours to get ready for school every day, but I was loving it, especially since all the kids and teachers thought I was really pretty.
2 hours to get ready? Yeah, no thanks. I think I'd rather be bald.
On Mother's Day, everyone's moms came to school, except mine and another girl's. She told me her name was Charlotte, and she didn't have a mom. I told her mine was too busy for me, and we became best friends that day.
Bonding over trauma. Perfect!
But I didn't tell her my secret. I was too afraid that she'd think I was a freak, too. Once in fifth grade, I was helping Charlotte with some math homework in my room when Mom walked in. It was her first time seeing Charlotte, and she was awestruck. You're such a beautiful child. I wish you were my daughter. If you want, I can adopt you. Charlotte looked freaked out, and I took her away immediately.
What was your mom talking about? You're the prettiest girl I've ever met. Even your grades are way better than mine. Oh, Mom's just a little crazy.
Maybe she didn't take her brain medicine today. After that, I only invited her when I was sure Mom was away.
Yeah, probably a good idea. So Mama don't have her mouth start watering over your friend again like she's staring at a juicy piece of meat. It's cool to be hungry and all, but don't eat the kids! Dang!
I managed to keep my secret well guarded, and by the time we reached ninth grade, I was one of the popular kids in school. I often wondered if people would be as friendly if they knew the truth about me.
Let's be real, probably not. Kids are ruthless.
One day at lunch, a group of cheerleaders came over and invited me to a grand pool party.
Yeah, sure. Me and Charlotte will be... No, ew.
Not Charlotte, just you. It's a party exclusively for the cool kids. Charlotte turned really red and was about to leave, but I turned to the cheerleaders and said,
Sorry, but if my BFF isn't coming, I'm not either.
Okay, fine. She can come. Whatever. On the day of the party, I was surrounded by a group of boys when suddenly Charlotte came running excitedly and pulled me aside.
You remember I told you about my crush? That new boy in my French class? He's here.
How do I look?
OMG, he's coming this way, Grace. He's coming to talk to me. What do I say?
Before I could think of a reply, the boy was already standing beside us. But instead of talking to Charlotte, he turned to me.
Hey, I'm Daniel. You're Grace, right? I've seen you around school a lot, and I think you're really pretty. Would you like to dance with me?
No! Grace, it's looking like you got yourself in a sticky situation. The cute boy likes you, but your best friend likes the cute boy. So what do you choose? Friendship? Or love. Yeah, the boy might bring you on cute dates and out for nice dinners. But if you don't have your best friend, who you gonna gossip with after those nice dinners and cute dates? I don't think your dog Rocky cares.
I wanted the ground to open up and swallow me. It felt so awkward. I couldn't even look at Charlotte's face. But then suddenly, Charlotte viciously pushed Daniel aside.
Oh, perfect! Looks like Charlotte already made the good decision and kicked that boy to the curb and is gonna walk off happily ever after with her best friend. That's the way it should be. Good job, Charlotte. I'm proud of you.
Seriously? You're such a witch. Oh. You're not even perfect, so stop acting like you are. Yeah, your mom told me your little secret a long time ago.
Oh, I guess I was wrong.
I guess Charlotte picked a boy.
And with that, Charlotte pushed me into the pool. As I sputtered and rose to the surface, I realized my wig had come off and was floating next to me. I touched my face to see streaks of makeup on my fingers. And then I saw everyone standing frozen in their spots, staring at me.
OMG, she has no hair. What a weirdo.
Look at her. She looks like Voldemort with a nose. Oh, really? How about I punch your face and turn you into Voldemort without the nose?
Daniel pushed those jerks aside and jumped into the water to help me out.
Are you okay?
I felt shocked and humiliated. As my eyes met Charlotte's, I saw complete hatred on her face. She turned around and walked away. I burst into tears and ran away from there. I couldn't believe my best friend would do this to me.
I mean, if she's willing to push you into a pool over a boy, imagine what she's willing to do over other things. Like if you stole the last bite of her McDonald's. I don't think that would be too pretty. You'd probably bite your arm off or something and say, oopsies, sorry. Thought it was a Big Mac.
When I got home, I locked myself inside my room. For days, I didn't step out. I didn't know how I would face anyone in school again. One night, Dad knocked on my door and sat down next to me.
Sweetheart, you can't hide forever. You have to go back to school.
You didn't see the looks on their faces or hear the things they were saying about me. I'm a freak, Dad. Mom was right all along.
No, she's not. You're beautiful. And more importantly, you're smart and kind. I'm sure your classmates were just surprised to see you that way. Trust me, when you get back, it won't make any difference to those kids who've always admired you.
Why is this scene touching my heart? The cute daddy-daughter talk, the dim light with the beautiful moon in the background. My story animated, you're really getting me into my feels.
Well, I made a big mistake of trusting Dad, and it turns out he doesn't know the first thing about high school. My popularity had tanked to rock bottom. I could hear everyone whispering and snickering behind my back. No one was inviting me to any parties anymore. One day, I walked to my locker to find a poster of E.T. stuck to it with the words, "Go back to your planet, Grace." And Charlotte, well, she had some newfound confidence after being a complete snake. She was wearing new clothes and shoes every day and had a flock of girls around her. She completely ignored me and I couldn't stand her face anyway, which is why I was horrified when I walked into my lounge one day to find her and Mom laughing and drinking tea. What is this witch doing here? That's no way to talk to my best friend. Your father really didn't teach you any manners.
Wait, sorry, did I miss something? The mom is now best friends with the daughter's ex-best friend? Dang, this mama really is psycho. How about you find someone your own age to be friends with? How about you don't be best friends with your daughter's ex-best friend? Just out of spite. I guess when one snake sees another snake, they see each other and want to do snake things together. Psychos! Seriously.
Your best friend? Grace, I really have to start thinking about who's going to be the face of my company one day. I mean, just look at that beautiful dark hair. Plus, Charlotte and I have always had a lot in common. Yeah, you're right about that, Mom. You're both awful people. And with that, I stormed off. A few weeks later, I was walking back from school when an older girl caught up with me. Ugh, maybe some bully from school. Hey, slow down. I want to talk. If you want to make fun of me, save yourself the trouble. I know I'm a hairless freak, okay?
Wait, really? I knew you were my half-sister, but I didn't know we had the same problem.
I turned around in shock. Wait, my what? She slowly took off her wig, and she was completely bald. She then went on to tell me the most shocking thing ever.
More shocking than being bald just like her and being your half-sister? Oh, please tell me more.
Your mom, I mean, our mom, she left me with Dad when I was just a baby. My dad was poor, and she married yours for his money. I've been searching for her, just so I can look her in the eye once and tell her that she's a terrible mother. My head was spinning. This couldn't be true. But then she did look like me. So, I'm just supposed to believe you? Just like that? No. That's why I have a picture of my birth certificate. And she showed me that on her phone.
Is that photo real? Family, do we trust it? Little bit of Photoshop nowadays and boom! You got a new birth certificate, driver's license, employee discount code to McDonald's? Yeah, you can do anything.
Sure enough, Mom's name was there. Come with me. When we got home, we walked straight into the dining room to find Mom and Dad there. And I told them everything. Mom looked horrified, while Dad was stunned.
You were married before? And you abandoned a child? And married me for money? And I made you the head of my company?
Oh, family, is it getting a little hot in here? I think so. Or maybe not so much for us, but I think the mom's 1 degree away from burning like a burnt chocolate chip. And not a tasty one.
That's it. I'm divorcing you. And I'll make sure you don't get a single penny. Leave my house. Now.
Mom begged and cried, but none of us felt sorry for her. She packed her bags and left weeping.
Bye, bitch! I mean, lady. Sorry, family, that one must have just slipped out.
Just as she was driving out, Charlotte turned up. But Mom didn't even bother to stop for her. She's gone for good, Charlotte, and she doesn't care about you. You should go too. Charlotte suddenly turned to me with a desperate face.
Please, forgive me, Grace.
You're the only friend I've ever had. I'm really sorry for what I did. I just got jealous of how perfect you always were.
Sorry, family. I just got an overwhelming sense of lies and BS.
All my hurt and anger bubbled over. Perfect? Do you think my life has been perfect with this condition? My own mom has always hated me. I didn't tell you my best friend because I thought you might reject me too. But you did something even worse. You betrayed me.
Ooh.
Just leave my life. She turned around and left crying. And I never saw her again. That's because I decided to transfer to a new high school. I needed a fresh start. My half-sister Bella and I kept in touch after she left, and we grew quite close. That year on Christmas, she invited me and Dad for a family dinner. When I got there, I was shocked to see Bella walking around and greeting all the guests without a wig. And I had to admit, she looked really good. A little girl came up to me and said,
"Are you my cousin Bella's sister? Are you special like her?"
I smiled. "Yes, I am." And from that day, I started to feel more comfortable with my condition. Sure, I still wore wigs and eyelashes in public, but I didn't feel the need to keep it a secret from my friends. Or from anyone, really. Oh, and about Daniel? We're dating. And I go out without my wig sometimes. And he loves me the way I am. And I love myself even more now.
Oh, family, will you look at that? A story about self-acceptance and self-love, and about filtering all the snakes out of your life. Cause they'd be more places than you think. Clearly, even your family.
Dang, that's cold.
And kinda scary, too. But I don't wanna have to go bald just to figure out who the snakes are. Can I just get a really short haircut instead? Please? But anyways, family, that is all of the true story animation that I have for you today. If you liked today's video, don't forget to smash that like button. And if you want to join our amazing family, all you got to do is hit that subscribe button, turn on all post notifications, and then you won't miss any of our videos. Also, don't forget to go follow me on my Instagram right down here. I love you all so much, and I'll see you all in the next video.